So I'm Mattias Ljungman from Atomico. I'm one of the partners who co-founded Atomico 11 years ago. And Christian, I'll let you introduce yourself.
Yeah, I'm Christian Faes, co-founder and CEO of LendInvest.
Perfect. So I just wanted to, let's start off with an important question. You know, why did you start LendInvest, and what was the sort of brainchild of the company?
Yeah, sure. So I think so. The mission of LendInvest is really to bring technology to the mortgage market here in the UK. The fact that it takes 3 months to get a mortgage and it's an entirely offline process is one that has to change. And I think we realize that, and we want to be the company that does that. In terms of our journey to realize that, it was kind of a bit longer than perhaps other startups. So we set up the business originally in 2008 as a short-term mortgage lending business. So we focused on bridging finance as an opportunity to create an investment asset class for investors. 2008 didn't feel like the best time to be setting up a mortgage lending business after we'd set it up. But we stuck at it, and we stayed as a funds management business. Sort of is where we got initial momentum. But it was very slow, and it was kind of hard work to raise capital. And then we were quite interested in technology and how we could use it. And we saw fintech sort of become a brand, and the government being supportive of fintech here in the UK. And the peer-to-peer platforms kind of caught our attention. We thought, you know, we're sort of traveling around the country trying to sell our fund to financial planners. And we had these sort of peer-to-peer competitors that had websites that were sort of raising capital. And so we thought, well, we need a website too. You know, it's kind of like initial sort of reaction to it. And then when we set up the platform and allowed investors to invest in our loans, we very quickly saw that we could raise capital quicker and easier through our platform than sort of through a fund. And so we saw the power of technology, I guess, have a real sort of impact on our business in that period. And so we really transformed the business to be very tech orientated and sort of, like I say, became quite aware of the fact that mortgages, in terms of the broader market beyond bridging, just really slow, really outdated. It, you know, it's the most outdated area of financial services. It's £300 billion a year, offline and very slow. So that was kind of our evolution to get involved.
Super. So basically, it was taking the efficiency of creating more efficient capital systems on the lending side, and then just making it much more quicker and efficient for the people who are borrowing, right, essentially?
Yeah, it is. And so it's more than, so initially it was raising capital, and then it's kind of trying to sort of improve the borrower experience as well. Yeah. I think we kind of come from it from the perspective that people will just expect mortgages to be online in the next couple of years. So we're very conscious of having to take the borrower experience online, but that's kind of, like I say, that is a given, and we'll get there. It's really using technology to create this marketplace platform. So it's bringing really deep sources of capital into the sphere and sort of allowing investors to invest in a mortgage that perhaps didn't have access to that asset class before. So in terms of the online investment platform, people can go online and sort of create their own portfolio of exposure to mortgages where, you know, before that wasn't something that was possible, through to now as we sort of scale up, you know, large institutions being very active in terms of buying our loans as well.
So what would be interesting too is just explain the product. So, I mean, you talked about the platform, but maybe walk through some of the products that you have.
Yeah, sure. So the core product, which is where we started, is kind of a niche area of the mortgage market, being bridging finance, so short-term mortgages.
How big is, like,
we say
the mortgage
niche,
market is £300 billion
market
in the UK.
In the UK, it's £4 to £5 billion a year, bridging finance alone. So it's kind of, it was a good place to start because the banks perceive it as niche, but for a business like ours, it's kind of a great opportunity because they're just not that active in it, and it requires the lender to move really quickly, which a bank is just not really geared up to do. So that was good, and you know, and then we started doing development finance, so it allowed borrowers to sort of acquire the property quickly and then able to fund them to develop their property. So it's kind of the product suite that a property entrepreneur wants, and that's what we describe our target customer as. And then as we've scaled up, like I say, institutions getting involved, so we've just announced a funding line from Citibank, which is really does deepen our capital base, and that's allowed us to launch into buy-to-let. So a 30-year mortgage now. So property entrepreneurs, that they acquire the property and they develop it, we can now allow them to hold on to it and sort of build their portfolio with us as their lender of choice.
Great. And so you're sort of moving and building with the customer.
Yeah, moving and building with the customer, and sort of as we've developed our technology and our processes and the speed around what we do, and what we think is probably, like we say, a niche area, but also the hardest area. In bridging finance, you typically have borrowers that are a little bit quirky, the property's a little bit unusual. So develop processes to be able to underwrite that in a very quick way, and then taking that to the broader market. So, like I say, the average mortgage in the UK takes 3 months. We lend on average within 14 days. And even with the sort of first few buy-to-let loans we've been doing them in under 12 days. So we're sort of getting to the point where we'll be able to lend to a borrower in a couple of days online and as price competitive as the more mainstream lenders.
So it'd be good to just understand you've been growing fairly fast. You've always managed to run a profitable business while growing super fast. Talk a little bit about that, but also talk about, you know, what's unique? You know, how do you distinguish yourself between other players on the market?
Yeah.
And how do you see yourself then, you know, becoming a category leader?
Yeah. So I think we're very well placed by virtue of the fact that we're not a bank. So we compete with banks, and as we know, banks generally have access to fairly cheap capital. But as we've seen, as we continue to build our platform and our marketplace proposition, bring more institutions into sort of the capital base that we've evolved. The funding line that we've recently got is cheaper than what we'd be able to raise bank deposits at. So that allows us to be very competitive on the price side, but we don't take on all of the bureaucracy and regulation that a bank takes on. You know, so we really have been given the opportunity to build a lender from the ground up and create a true platform that provides a far superior experience to the borrower.
Great. Okay, so if we move on then, in terms of the vision and where do you see LendInvest going over the next few years? You know, what's the ambition level?
Yeah, sure. So I mean, the ambition level is to be a whole of mortgage market provider here in the UK. And once we have established a significant presence here, you know, we do £500 million this year in a £300 billion market. We've got a bit of runway to go. But to continue to develop the technology so that we're an extremely efficient business as well. Mm-hmm. Like you say, we've been profitable for the last 4 years. So we've been growing at a sensible pace, but hopefully we can create an origination machine on the mortgage side. So just to put some color around that, if we look at another sort of comparable lender that is bigger than us, it's a listed business, Paragon. They'll lend about £1 billion this year, but they'll have 1,300 people in the business. So we'll lend over £500 million this year with 120 people in the business.
Amazing.
In the next sort of 18 months, we'll be lending over £1 billion a year, so comparable sort of volumes with less than 200 people. So it's really developing technology that really drives core efficiencies, which again allows us to sort of be very price competitive and remain very nimble and create products that really borrowers want, as opposed to adhering to bank-like regulation being laid upon us.
Cool. And in terms of competition in the market, other people, players, you know, like, how does that look like for you?
We kind of don't have a huge amount of tech-enabled competition. So in the UK, we have challenger banks, and we're very close to a number of them. It's kind of interesting in the sense they've come under the tagline of being challengers, but in many respects they're kind of just new banks. They've taken sort of legacy systems off the shelf and created interesting businesses, but haven't really done anything particularly dynamic. It's still very intermediated in terms of their mortgage origination and so on. So for us, we go head to head with those guys, but as, like I say, with those efficiencies and the speed and so forth, it's kind of just educating the market that there is the ability to get finance as quickly as we provide it, and also that they can use the online tools and all the rest of it. So it's kind of becomes increasingly a sales game for us to sort of to take more market reach.
Great. Well, we got 10 seconds left, so I'd just like to thank. Yeah.
We have to congratulate you for keeping the time. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Great business.
Thank you very much.
And good luck.
Cheers, Mark.
All right.